Hi, today we're going to go over sub-Q fluid administration using the syringe method. So you want to make sure you have all your supplies, your bag of fluids, a syringe, a butterfly needle, and a needle. The syringe will be opened using a tab at the top of the covering. The butterfly needles also have a tab at the top. So, screw the plastic cap off the top of the needle, place at the end, and gently screw into the locking mechanism of the needle. Pull the plastic cap straight off to reveal the needle. As you can see on the fluid bag, we have two ports here. We'll be using this port to inject the needle and obtain our fluids. Hold the bag upside down to prevent any air from getting into the syringe, and gently pull back. You can see that sometimes air will still get into the top. No worries, just gently push the plunger back in to put all the air back into the bag. You'll want to draw back enough fluids so that you have enough for whatever amount you'll be giving to your pet to the top of the black stopper. So I would like to give 10 mils. So I'm going to make sure that the top of the black stopper reaches the top of the line of the number 10. To place the cap back on the needle, you'll want to use the scoop method, where you can gently place the needle into the covering and scoop it up, then secure it onto the needle. Twist it off to remove it from the syringe. Taking your butterfly needle, you'll take the plastic cap off the top, screw it onto the syringe, and push the plunger to help a little fluid go through the line. You want to make sure that you're not giving any air to your pet. When you feel like the line has enough fluid in it, you can find the sub-Q space on your pet. So sub-Q just means all the space that's between the skin and the muscle. We tend to use between the shoulder blades because there's a lot of space there and it's the least sensitive to placing a needle. Take the plastic cap off the top of the needle. Gently use your first three fingers to pinch the skin and pull up towards the ceiling. You should feel a small pocket between your fingers. Into this pocket, insert the needle. You want to go straight towards the wall, not down, not up. Once it's securely in, pull back on the plunger a little bit to make sure there's no blood. If a little bit of air or a negative pressure is seen, that is okay. Gently give the fluids. Once you have finished giving all the fluids that you need to, pull the needle straight back out. Sometimes blood or fluid might drip out. That's totally normal. It just means you might have hit a small skin vessel. You can use gauze or a piece of paper towel to hold onto the spot for a few minutes and you should not see any more bleeding. You should see a large lump where the fluids were given. That's perfectly normal and the body will absorb it within 24 hours or less. Sometimes the lump will shift over the around the body due to gravity, and that is totally normal as well.